Mr. Holtham.
Present.
Mr. Kofel.
Present.
McHale is present. Mr. Summa.
Present.
Mr. Muracco.
Present.
Stand for the pledge of allegiance. Please stand afterwards, please.
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
This afternoon, I have a moment of silence for a former employee of Dunmore School District, Kathy McLean.
Quinn was looking into it with guidance.
Okay.
That's been brought up before, but Mr. Hopkins, you're aware of that. You're aware. So they're looking at that. Okay. You can call things each other. There's a lot of names, but they're all going to have some kind of patients.
I agree. I just think those two are. And I just wanted to bring up that I think our students are immersed in technology, even in eighth grade. They're commenting online when someone does a presentation in their eighth grade class. The kids are all on computers and they instantly give their feedback on that presentation. And they're grading not only on their feedback but also on their presentation. A site called Moodle that they use all the time. In the high school, they're using Turnitin. So I type my three-page paper to make sure nothing was plagiarized. They go through Turnitin. The teacher doesn't have to read through every one and check every website. And they're emailing their teachers assignments and bringing them back. So I feel like technology and the internet are so important. And I'm thrilled to see the district webpage with some excellent information. There was Mr. Farris' woodshop projects were like out of this world. I told him that they were fabulous. There's more pictures today. I know parents whose kids' pictures on the Facebook page, trying to say it wrong, for the science award that they won, their parents are thrilled. Like, it's really nice to be able to say, you know, my son or daughter is on the high school website. Go look at their picture. I just think as a parent, there's a proud moment. One thing though, when you click on the middle school website, it tells you how to register your child for school in September. And the only two things that were on there so far were the two things that I'm the PTA secretary that I forwarded to Mrs. Ahern to put on. So, district site's awesome, high school site's good. Middle school, not so good. Elementary is good. So I think sometimes it just gets lost in the shuffle. And I know because it's only two grades, but you know, God forbid your kid, you only have one kid in eighth grade, you're missing out on things. So some people do that. And I believe it was last week or the week before the new PA school performance profiles were out, 2013-2014 school performance profile. And I just wanted to know how much progress we made from the 2012, 2013 year to 2014. Because I know it all just came out like 2 weeks ago. I tried to.
It came out, it's not public yet.
Right, that's what I thought.
It's not public yet. I can tell you how we did. Our elementary school went down 6 points.
Okay.
Our middle school went up 2 points, which they were very high last year to begin with. And our high school went up 15 points. So overall, I think our score was a little bit higher than last year. What they did, I don't know if you know, that they ranked the schools across the state. And I put it in the board's package tonight, Dunmore from 12-13 was number two in the Lackawanna County. And we're number five out of the NEIU 19 schools. 12-13. 13-14, they're having problems because all their data is not correct. So they were supposed to release that profile 2 weeks ago, and now they just told us, they'll let us know when it's ready.
Okay. Also, are those scores going to be able to be compared? Because now that it's, you know, how it was in the middle and high school, and now it's junior high school?
I was told, we were approved for the reconfiguration that I applied for. But I was told by our curriculum director last week that Harrisburg says they're not going to change anything for 3 more years. Yes, I was not supposed to do that. It's almost like they're working against you.
Yeah.
So.
Coaching, and more importantly, teaching student athletes on the cross-country team. Our son Will did it last year, Libby's doing it this year. Everything he's teaching them about life above and beyond the sport is incredible. So I hope he stick around for 45 more years. And then also like to recognize the boys' soccer team for the great season they're having, and the job Mr. Phillips has done coaching them. They're an incredible, incredible set of athletes. If anybody's not seen the game or a match, incredible to watch how fast they are and how well coached they are. Like they're having a good season. Just a quick statement. My son is in the honors program, and his transition from 8th grade to 9th grade has been incredible. He's beyond happy as a freshman at Dunmore High School. First week of school, can't make it up, guys, and it is. His first week of school, he came home and announced that he was bored in lunch and that he needed a book. So I know the point being, it made what little hair I have left on my head hurt. And that's been our overriding point for 2 years now. So, Mr. McHale, I know that you had a meeting. Can you fill us in the last meeting with the scheduling consultant?
Got it. We did have a meeting with our guidance and our administrative team and our schedule. There were a number of options that we looked at. We chose two. Some of them were very unrealistic. Two options. We asked him to go back and try to match teachers to that option. One was a 9-period day, where all the periods were 42 or 43 minutes, and one's an 8-period day with some flex time. I think the lunch will have that. He had 30 minutes or 33 minutes. I don't know that either one of them are going to, we can work the 9-period day, but I think it's going to be very expensive. This right here is an issue. The gymnasium is an issue, because you know, we even looked at starting both schools together. There's not enough space here, and there's not enough gym space. So we're going to have them back up hopefully next week to look at the 8th period day, what is the flex time, where we are with that. The board, I just informed them tonight of what the 9th period day would entail. It would require additional staff, as that back in 2012, our principals told us the same thing. It requires additional staff. So that's where we're at. Hopefully he'll be up within the next 2 weeks to look at that 8-period flex day. And then the board will have to make a decision whether we do change something or don't change anything. It's not as easy as people think it can be. And our principal, Mr. Hopkins, Doc Bennett, our chemistry teacher, they worked on that 2 years ago. It's hard to do without having additional staff to do that 9-period day. I was more in favor of the 9-period day because I thought we could have done some things with this remediation plan. Students have to have now because of the but that's what we're looking at, and that's where we're at.
And I guess another point that another parent brought up, maybe it helps the schedule, I don't know. What about switching? Not training them all at the same time, but what about switching the high school to the earlier start time and middle school to the later start time? Not specifically just for the schedule, but for, again, sporting activities and travel.
We talked about that. That's still a possibility to do. However, last year, when we looked at it in the spring sports last year, Mr. Mr. Hopkins is here. I believe there were only two or three occasions when students got out of class early. This year there was a couple because of the golf districts, which doesn't matter if you're, what schedule you're on. They got to go early.
Yeah.
And the tennis districts, the kids have to go early. Other than that, I don't know, Mr. Hopkins, there's many times.
Just a couple trips that we went to Montrose and Elk Lake. Yeah,
those types of lawns, that's, that, those, the one golf tournament matches in New York.
Yeah, on
the you're not going to change that.
No.
That's just the way it is.
That's normal.
Yeah. But we've cut back on that. And I brought up to the LIA last year, and we told them.
We also moved the starting time in the spring of 4:30, so we don't have to get out of school.
So we got that covered pretty good. There's only a few times.
I know you're working really hard on the schedule. Just praying and then. That's all.
Right.
So, and then this was neat. I hadn't even thought about it until I saw it on the agenda. Tonight you have approval of the dual enrollment program at Lackawanna.
Yes.
Do we have that in place with Keystone University of Strength and Engineering?
And we've had them in place. So I was the coordinator with the University of Strength for 10 or more years, with Marywood for 10 or more years. Our kids, generally, I think in my time, only one of the kids have taken the Marywood courses. We had it with Penn State. 10 or more years, which lots of kids took harder, but the state removed the funding for that. So I don't think too many kids take Penn State courses anymore. But we still have a dual enrollment degree with them. We have one with Luzerne County Community College, which I started about 2 or 3 years ago. The problem with that one is that's quite a distance away. And Lackawanna, this just started 2 years ago, and this is working pretty successfully. You do get those credits for that. So that is there. But we've had them in place for many, many years. You can take the scholars program at the University of Scranton, you can charge $500, and you get the 3 credits. You can say, Penn State, the way the state had it set up, Penn State or Marywood, they would pay a third, the state would pay a third, student would take a third, so it was a pretty good deal. So really the student was paying 1/3. The state that was under the old governor, they always had money left over, so our kids got reimbursed for everything. They never had to pay a dime out of pocket. But all that funding went away, all of it. So you still can take the courses, but the state's not paying a third. You're gonna, I think Penn State you're gonna have to pay half and the kids are gonna have to pay half.
The one you didn't so Marywood,
we had that, and I don't think it's been active. I have an agreement with them. I went down 3 or 4 times. We had a couple students take it there. I believe it's still on the paper if they wanted to do it. I think there were a little more money. I thought they were, but I'm not sure.
But all accessible if
yes.
We chose to pursue it.
Yes.
I did. I know my son took a social sociology class in summer. From different schools, they're all college students. They have 3 credits and this was $500. Teacher told them to take it because they take 4 times.
Central. And like, they're just painting a picture, everybody said. And maybe there's a way to make it more, let's hope the state perhaps next year brings something like that. But it's literally, we have another friend whose daughter's at Holy Cross. There's nothing where she's going, but she's taking advantage of that. She's going to go into college. 15 credits, and that's very low rate. So why it's so important to a lot of people instead of something.
Then just give me a call or the guidance or the principal. Lackawanna's are embedded. They're taking it here.
Oh, okay.
They're actually, they're here. So those are courses being taught by our teachers, which is what you pay. And Mr. Hopkins has more details on that. Hey, I don't think your kids aren't old enough.
Yeah.
They're embedded here. Penn State, they were usually juniors or seniors that went, and the same for Marywood. I thought the university took like ninth grade, we thought for the scholarship program. They have not.
Very good. Thanks for everybody's time.
Thank you.
Anyone else for public discussion? Thank you.
please? Mr. Chairman, the permission be granted to the following for the use of district facilities and equipment. Request from the PIAA track and field officials of the DHS cafeteria. Request from Ryan Ferguson, DEC Kids Night Out. Request from Tony Lasatosa, pre-season conditioning DHS gym. The use of district facilities is subject to the conditions established by the Dunmore School District and may not conflict with any regularly scheduled activity.
Motion by Mr. Butler.
Second.
Second by Mr. Silva. All in favor?
Aye.
Against? Hearing none, motion passes.
Motion to accept the personnel reports.
So moved.
Motion by Mr. Hallinan. Second by
Second.
Mr. Muracco. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Against? Hearing none, motion passes. Motion, please.
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Holtham. Motion to approve FMLA for Jennifer Dempsey.
Motion by Mr. Holtham.
Second.
By Mr. Kofel. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion passes. Motion, please.
Chairman.
Mr. McHale.
Approve student political affiliation agreement for music therapy for Mary University.
Motion by Mr. McHale.
Second.
Second by Mr. Hallinan. All in favor?
Aye.
No, hearing none, motion passes. Motion to approve dual enrollment agreement with Lackawanna College.
So moved.
Motion by Mr. Kofel. Second by Mr. Silva. All in favor?
Aye.
No, hearing none, motion passes. Motion to approve agreement with PAT PA Treatment and Healing for 2014-2015 school year.
So moved.
Motion by Mr. Hallinan.
Second.
Second by Mr. Butler. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye, hearing none, motion passes. Motion, Mr. Muracco.
Motion to approve the following payrolls. September 12, 2014, $323,641.91. September 26, 2014, $345,430.29 for a grand total of $669,072.20.
Motion by Mr. Muracco. Second by Mr. McHale. All in favor?
Aye.
No, hearing none, motion passes. Motion to accept the treasurer's report for the month of September 2014.
So moved.
Motion by Mr. McHale, second by Mr. Hallinan. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye, motion passes. Motion to accept the real estate tax collection report for the month of September 2014.
So moved.
Motion by Mr. Hallinan.
Second.
Second by Mr. Muracco. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye, hearing none, motion passes. Motion, Mr. Muracco.
Motion to approve the payment of the list of bills, $416,322.64.
Motion by Mr. Muracco, second by Mr. McHale. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye, hearing none, motion passes. Motion to accept the activity report for the month of September 2014.
So moved.
Motion by Mr. Hamilton, second by Mr. Kofel. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye, hearing none, motion passes. Motion, please.
Chairman.
Mr. Suma.
To approve wage tax collector report for the month of September 2014.
Motion by Mr. Suma.
Second.
Second by Mr. Kofel. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye, hearing none, motion passes. Any new business? Hearing none. No presence reported at this time. Superintendent's report, Mr. McDonald.
Yes, at this time I would like to acknowledge Mr. Lucas and members of the senior class who organized the annual pickoff of the tour. Our students sold pink t-shirts and had competition among the different classes during Spirit Week. To raise money for breast cancer awareness, they raised $2,150 for the Northeast PA affiliate of the Susan G. Komen Foundation. Also, the entire district had a dress down day to raise money for Corporal Dixon's fund. Between the DEC and Dunmore High School collection at the Friday night football game, over $5,000 was raised, and that will be forwarded to their fund. And also our phys ed teacher, Gianna Muracco, organized a Zumba fundraiser for the Dixon family. That was last Thursday, where they raised over $800 for their family. So I want to thank everybody for their hard work and their generosity.
Motion to accept the superintendent's report and make required amendments.
So moved.
Motion by Mr. Hanlon, second by Mr. Muracco. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Hearing none. Motion passes. Motion to adjourn and convene the regular session of the college chair.
So moved.
Motion by Mr. Suma.
Second.
Second by Mr. Muracco. All in favor?
Aye.
Meeting adjourned.